Hello students, we will be starting with a new topic today, chapter amines. This topic has been divided in four units, and the first unit is about introduction, classification, nomenclature and isomerism of amines. So let us begin first with the definition of amines itself. Amines are nitrogen containing organic compounds which are obtained by replacing 1, 2 or 3 all the hydrogen atoms of ammonia by either same or different alkyl or aryl groups. We can see different examples of amines. As we know, ammonia has a formula NH3. If I replace one hydrogen of it, I will get a structure CH3NH2, which we call in common system as methyl amine. Similarly, I can replace two hydrogen atoms of ammonia by two ethyl groups. We get a structure called diethyl amine. On the other hand, we can replace all the three hydrogen atoms of ammonia to get a structure, say trimethyl amine. We will be classifying also amines on a similar basis. We can have amines containing aryl groups also. Here we can see a structure of aniline. Another case is where aromatic ring is not directly connected to the nitrogen atom. This example is benzyl amine. Whatever structures we see right now, we must byheart them well for methods of preparation as well as reactions. Let us now learn about the classification of amines. And the first type is known by the name primary amine, denoted by 1 degree. This group is known by the name amino group, and it is denoted with a symbol -NH2. We can see an example of it as C2H5NH2, called ethyl amine. The second type is called secondary amine. There are two types of it, symmetrical amine and unsymmetrical secondary amine. Both are given a general name, imino group, and it is shown with two bonds NH. For symmetrical amine, both the groups connected to the nitrogen atom are similar. For example, here we can see dimethyl amine. For unsymmetrical amines, the groups will be different. For example, here it is ethyl methyl amine. We have taken here examples of only alkyl groups, but you can very well think of examples with aromatic ring also. The third type is called tertiary amine. This is also divided as symmetrical and unsymmetrical, and it is generally known with a name tertiary nitrogen. It is a nitrogen with three bonds. Examples are CH3 thrice N, which is nothing but trimethyl amine, or CH3 twice NC2H5, which is ethyl dimethyl amine. Here, in case of unsymmetrical amines, we can have all the three groups also different. Let us come to the nomenclature of amines. And first we learn about the common system. In common system, the amines are named as alkyl amines. Note the way it is written, it is without a gap, alkyl amine. If the amines are mixed amines, then the names of alkyl groups are prefixed in alphabetical order. Consider some examples. Here we can see an amine N-propyl group connected to amine N-propyl amine. Another similar one is isopropyl amine. Cyclohexyl group connected to amine is called cyclohexyl amine. Here we have a compound with two amine groups, which is ethylene diamine. Now certain words of precaution here. You can see the group isopropyl amine compound. Now, what sort of amine is it? It is a primary amine. But what sort of alkyl group do we have here? It is a secondary alkyl group. Now this becomes quite a confusion in the beginning, because we are used to use the words primary, secondary, tertiary always with respect to carbon atom. But when we say a primary amine, it is not with respect to carbon, but it is with respect to nitrogen. So once again, primary amine indicates NH2, secondary amine will indicate NH, and a tertiary amine will indicate only N. Secondary and tertiary alkyl groups prefixes di and tri are used if the groups are similar. For example, here we can see two methyl groups connected to NH, so it is dimethyl amine. If the groups are different, then we say in alphabetical order ethyl methyl amine. Here a tertiary group is there, tertiary nitrogen. It is connected to all the three groups similar, so it's trimethyl amine. Here all the groups are different, so we say ethyl methyl N-propyl amine. In case of aromatic amines, C6H5NH2 is called aniline and it is the accepted common system name. All other aryl amines will be named as derivatives of aniline only. Let us come to now IUPAC nomenclature of amines. Basic rules are quite similar. We select the longest continuous chain of carbon atom in amines. For secondary and tertiary amines, longest chain is selected from the alkyl group with maximum carbon atoms. The number of the chain is given from that end which is nearest to the amine group. The name is written with a number N, amino alkane, or alkan N amine, where N is the locant group. In secondary and tertiary alkyl group attached to the nitrogen atom, prefix capital N is used. And for aromatic amines, the E of arene is replaced with the word amine. So if it is benzene, it is written as benzene, E is deleted and amine is written for it. Let us see some concrete examples. Let us imagine this case now. Here you can see NH2 group is connected to a 3 carbon atom chain. So NH2 is connected to the first carbon atom of the chain. So the name will be propan-1-amine. Here also you can see propane's E has been deleted. Now imagine this particular chain. The 3 carbon atom chain is there, but NH2 is now connected to the second carbon atom. So what will be the name of it? Propan-2-amine. Now you can see a cyclohexane ring is connected to the amine group, so it will be called cyclohexane amine. The example which we took earlier, we have a 2 carbon atom chain connected to amine groups, so the name will be ethane 1,2 diamine. Here, since there is a vowel rule used, the ethane's E has been retained as it is. Come to a secondary amine now, and 2 methyl groups are connected to nitrogen. So this will be called N-methyl methanamine. So what rule are we using here? We consider CH3NH2, CH3NH2 as the parent compound, that is methanamine. To the nitrogen of methanamine, methyl group is connected. Hence the name is capital N, then methyl methanamine. Similarly now, if you have this compound, here we can see 2 different groups. So as per the rule, the larger group, longer chain will be the parent compound. So which is the parent amine over here? 2 carbon atoms, ethanamine. And to ethanamine's nitrogen, methyl group is connected. So it becomes N-methyl ethanamine. Now comes a tertiary amine. Here we consider once again 1 as the parent group. So suppose CH3NH2 is the parent group. 2 two methyl groups are connected to the nitrogen atom. So the name becomes N, N dimethyl methanamine. Every compound of amine is considered as parent compound primary amine. The groups connected to nitrogen are selected as the side chains. Now we imagine an example where all the three groups are quite different: CH3, N, C3H7 and C2H5. So one group is methyl, second group is ethyl and third group is propyl. So the longest chain is going to be propan 1-amine, to which N ethyl is connected, N methyl is connected. Imagine some additional examples which mostly JEE mains advanced and few NEET students will need it. These are the heterocyclic nitrogen containing compounds, and we will think of as primary, secondary, tertiary also here. For example, we can see compounds called pyrrol, pyrrolidine, imidazole. Think on your own, each nitrogen atom, whether it is primary, secondary or even tertiary. Another group of compounds are pyridine, piperidine, pyrimidine and pyrazine. Two cyclic compound is indole. Quinoline and isoquinoline differ in position of nitrogen. Purine and pyrimidine are the famous bases which are present in DNA and RNA. These examples are sheerly extra examples. In case they ask in exam, you should know them. We come to the last point of this isomerism in amines. Amines have general formula CnH2n+3n. All the amines show chain isomerism, and secondary and tertiary amines can show metamerism also. Let us see examples of isomerism. We will take it as value of N. If N is 1, the formula you can see and calculate, it is C1, H will be 5 and nitrogen 1. This can give you only one compound, CH3NH2. This amine is a primary type of amine. If N equal to 2, the formula comes out to be C2H7N, and the compound is only one primary amine, ethanamine. For N equal to 3, we can generate one compound which is primary amine and second one is a secondary amine. Both the compounds are primary amine only. It's written by mistake here secondary. Please make a correction and take it as primary only. When N equal to 4, we can have primary amines as butan-1-amine and butan-2-amine, 2-methylpropan-1-amine and 2-methylpropan-2-amine. All the four compounds are primary only. Under secondary, we have three compounds: N-methylpropan-1-amine, N-methylethanamine and N-ethylethanamine. And for tertiary, N, dimethyl ethanamine. The list of isomerism is a quite frequent question in most of the competitive exams. Most of the textbooks do not give you this information. So in your writing material somewhere, you add up these compounds with N equal to 1 to N equal to 4. We are completing here about the basic introduction of amines. In the second lecture, we will be taking the methods of preparation of amines.